Hi, this is Elia. Welcome to my channel, and this is a 5-minute presentation series where I explain technical things in 5 minutes in a very high level. So today I'm going to talk about LiDAR, and let's get started. I'm going to talk about what is LiDAR first, and then why we want to use it, and then how does the data look, and how to map and localize. The LiDAR stands for light detection and ranging. And why do we want to use it? Because we want to know not only the distance, but also the distance of surrounding of its own sensor. So what do I mean by that? The light will be emitted here from this emission port, and then light will travel until it hits an object. Then whenever this light hits an object, it will be reflected, and then it will get back to its receiver here. And then it knows the time difference, and then we know the speed of the light. So the distance to this object is going to be time difference times speed of the light. Now you can calculate this really quick. Nowadays, it's not really a big deal. And that it keeps rotating for 360 degrees so that it can measure all the distance of its surroundings. And before we talk about our data set, let's assume this kind of environment. And here's your robot. And then on top of it, let's assume there is LiDAR emitting all the rays. And before we hit an object, like a wall or a pillar or whatever that is, it measures the distance. And before every iteration, it reports about 200 to 400 data points. This is a zero angle. And as it twists through 90 degree, 80 degree, it reports the distance per that angle. So this is a sample LiDAR data set look like. And this is a map. And then this robot is traveling at this point, and then again it emits all the rays, right? And then whenever it hits the closest point, which is about negative 100 degrees here, and then the distance is really close to its LiDAR. And then as the sweep angle goes up, the distance to the wall increases until it hits this pillar. And before we then, the distance drops all of a sudden. And then do the same thing for the other wall, and then it hits an object, second object, third object, and fourth object. And before we view, it's the same in the polar coordinate, like this. Distance is really small, but as the sweep angle goes up, the distance, this point increases until it hits an object. Then after it hits an object, there is a shadow because there's no light touching this part because it's blocked by this object. As the robot travels here, and then the perspective of the LiDAR keeps changing, and then your local coordinate at 0.0, it doesn't move because the LiDAR is on top of it. In a very high level view, you want to use an automatic information like how many wheel, how many angle rotated second and so on. And then using that information, you want to mix with the LiDAR data set so that eventually you can create your own estimation for your position. And then you can also create the map in real time. And after, I don't know, 0.02 second later, you do the same thing all over again. And then you can eventually create entire map of your robot's journey. As your robot moves, you can create all the maps like where the pillars are. So that's about how you can use the LiDAR dataset in your localization project.